What's up? Hey, this is Darnell Jackson at youronline.biz, and it's Social Media Saturday. So that means it's time for me to share the latest tips on social media from the past week with you. All right, now if you haven't been following social media, definitely check out the main page and get caught up on all the previous episodes. This is episode number 7. You definitely don't want to miss last week's episode where I talk about Mindy McCready. Rest in peace. And the previous episode where I talk about why the Pope quit. So check those out and get some great tips on social media. Now, this episode is going to be really quick, so I'm going to get right into a really great tip that I want to share with you. This is more of a case study for anybody that's out there and wants to grow their social media presence and do a better job of growing their interaction. So I just want to share with you the results of what happened for me this past week. All right, I want to start off first. I'm going to give a shout out to everybody who follows me on Twitter. Yes, you can follow me on Twitter at FreedomMMC. So I want to give a shout out to everybody who's followed me or retweeted anything that I have done on Twitter. I appreciate that. So everybody on the page here, I'm giving a big shout out to you. Everybody from the past week, Eddie Gear, what's up, man? I read one of your articles. Excellent. Big shout out to Eddie Gear. And everybody who has Adrian Smith, who is a really good blogger. A lot of these awesome. Annabelle Candy, who is in Australia. That just shows you that you can connect with people internationally on social media. And I appreciate Annabelle taking the time to do an interview with me this past week. Make sure you check that out. Shout out to Carol Tice, Kathy Miller, and everybody else who has followed or retweeted me. All right, now let me jump into my tip for this episode of Social Media Saturday. It is about GooglePlus. So if I jump over to Google, all right, when I type in Google, here's the thing. I want you to take a look. You'll notice that I have my status update scrolls there with, you know, since I've last logged in. So there's been some interaction. And I want to share with you why this is happening and what the difference is for me in this past week. And so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to jump over. I'm going to do this live. Everything I do is real, so I don't even know what these updates are. I'm looking at this live. So what I want to do is I'm just going to view all my notifications. And I want to share with you a big tip that revealed a big difference for me on Google. So you can see all the people who have added me back here. So big shout out to everybody that's added me on GooglePlus. Add all these people to your circles. All right. Big shout out to Matt Smith, who I was fortunate enough to also do an interview. And he is another blogger who's located in London or in UK. And he is, another example where you can, you know, interact with people internationally. Learned a lot from Matt. So big shout out to him and everybody else that's followed or added me to their circles. So let me just share with you what is the biggest reason for growing my interaction. And here you can see a bunch more people that's added me. How am I able to generate the interaction? Well, what I want to do first, let me go back to my profile. And I want you to know, if you've read my post, then you know I talk about hashtag hijacking. No doubt about it, I am a prolific hashtag hijacker. So when it comes to promoting my site, you know, I tend to, you know, try to use the hashtags as a way to, you know, leverage attention to my latest articles. And I have been doing that this year, and I wanted to kind of switch things up and really increase the quality of my interactions. So you can see, you know, whenever something was trending, like the Oscars, then I would post an article that I had written related to the Oscars. So this is my example of hashtag hijacking. So you want to target a hashtag or a topic. And if you do it right, like I wrote this article, you know, several weeks before the Oscars. So as the news was building up about the Oscars, you know, I knew this topic would be trending. So you really want to forecast when you hashtag hijack. So I have been doing that, but as you can see, this post is getting no interaction. So nobody's really, you know, saying anything to me about the fact that I'm posting an article, even though it's related to this trending topic. So yeah, hashtag hijacking is effective, but is it the most effective technique at building interaction on social media? Well, here's what I did this past week. I decided instead of posting links to my articles that I would just talk to people and really focus on building connections. So let me share with you a little bit. So you can see here's another example of where I share a link to an article. All right, so I got a few comments, you know, and I get interactions regularly on things I post. So this started when I posted this comment, which was give people good advice. That way you get used for the right reason. And I mean that. So I decided to say, okay, I'm gonna just talk to people plainly and see what happens. So let me just show you the results of what happened when I started doing that. What I did in GooglePlus was I went into the communities, and I recommend you join communities because there are people there that are already interested in the topics that you want to discuss. So let me just show you one perfect example of a comment I made this week in a community that generated a ton of feedback. So let me go to that comment here. Let me scroll down and you'll see that I posted a comment and it says here, okay, I'm gonna click it here. And it says, what came first? Simple question, what came first, the chicken or the egg? I will link to this and I want you to read the comments and give me feedback on your thoughts about this discussion. It's something we've been talking about since we were able to talk, as far as I could remember. But anyway, it just shows that if you find the right topic, people are motivated to get interactive. So as you can see, 39 comments on this post. So, you know, this reflects my personality. I think about, you know, just you know, philosophy, right? So this was a comment I posted for the Philosophy of Mind community. So shout out to the moderators. Thanks for having me. So you may want to join that and start talking to people about thoughts that you may have. But when I was able to, when I posted my comment, you may be shocked to see some of the reactions and some of the things that people said. Here's another example where I posted a comment and I said, fill in the blank Friday. And I asked a question. You know, I just wanted to say, you know, hey, fill in the blank. I blank, therefore I am. So this brought 39 comments. Okay. And so it just gives you an idea of, you know, instead of promoting my site, changing my you know, primary objective into just talking to people and just having conversation and discussion, it definitely made a big impact. So I went from, you know, less than two or three comments or plus ones to 39 comments just from pretty much just being myself and talking to people about the types of things that that I think about, really. So big shout out to everybody that you know, that's getting involved with some of these topics that I'm starting. I appreciate your comments, and you can follow me on GooglePlus. I am Darnell Jackson. So definitely add me to your circles and follow me on Twitter, and check out Social Media Saturday for more useful tips to help you improve on social media every week. I just share with you what works for me, and I also share other tips that I find from the week. So if you have some great tips or anything you want to share, send them my way, and I would appreciate it. Until the next time, peace.